Selamat pagi, guru dan teman-teman sekalian. Nama kita, namanya, semua namanya saya akan taruh untuk di end credit scene-nya. Jadi kalau pengen, lah, ya, di end, di terakhir. So, for today, you're about to witness our video ujian praktek Bahasa Inggris X SBK. Yeah, so, that's basically the title. And tanpa lama-lama lagi, ya, yeah, let's get into the storytelling. Prepare your popcorns, prepare your drinks, yeah, because we're going to talk about, yes, Aladdin.
Aladdin, a story about a kid named Aladdin. He goes on a pretty amazing adventures that resolve around this pretty looking ordinary lamp. It's a dark stormy night and then there's this villain called Jafar. He needs to go to this weird cave in the middle of the desert to get his hand on the magical lamp. So he can finally realize that his big evil dream of becoming sultan and ruling everyone.
Jasmine can't take the pressure of Felice's life anymore, so she sneaks out one night and makes her way into the town. There, she manages to get her hand nearly cut off but is saved by Aladdin. It's a total dreamboat, but their romance takes a turn for the worse when the palace guard capture Aladdin. Jasmine tries to use her princess privilege to get him set free, but it's not good. This order comes straight from the top, Jafar. Yes, turn out that creepy villain from the beginning of the movie is also the royal vizier, which means his right-hand man to Jasmine Dad, the Sultan of Agrabah. He's also really great at running Jasmine life every change he got.
Luckily, Aladdin's pet monkey name is Abu. He's able to snatch the lamp from the old man, so Aladdin and Abu went up, trapped inside the cave with a friendly magic carpet anyway. On the plus side, the old man, who was Jafar in disguise, all alone doesn't get to lay his slimy fingers on his prize.
Down in the cave, Aladdin wraps the lamp and discovers that it contains a wise cracking genie who will grant him 3 wishes. Once the genie uses his magic to free them from the cave, Aladdin makes his first wish. He wants to be a prince to catch Jasmine eyes.
Aladdin, disguised as Prince Ali, he rolls into town in style, but Jasmine is not impressed. And then genie encourages Aladdin or Prince Ali to be himself. Then Aladdin ignores him and then Jasmine ignores him for the rest of the process. Finally, man's got some luck. He finally gets a time alone with Jasmine and take her on his magic carpet and then fly around the city.
Back on solid ground, Jafar has Aladdin kidnapped and thrown into the sea. See, now that Jafar doesn't have the lamp, he's got to take the matter into his own hand. The civil plane involves forcing Jasmine into marrying him, so that he can become sultan.
Meanwhile, genie has to save Aladdin from drowning, which used up one of his wishes, or you could say his second wish. Aladdin arrives back at the palace just in time to foil Jafar's evil.
Aladdin sort of nervous because he's been essentially lying to everyone this whole time. He's not actually a prince. What if they find out he's a fraud? Plus, he told genie he would use his third wish to free him from a lifetime servitude. But he can't do that now. He needs the genie help. And one other rumor is that Jafar has been seen Aladdin with the lamp and knows exactly who he is. We get the feeling that's gonna be his biggest problem.
Of course, we're right. Jafar sent his pet bird Ligo to snatch the lamp and then uses it to start making evil wishes. Poof, Jafar is now sultan. Poof, Jafar is now the most powerful sorcerer in the entire world.
But Aladdin manages to find his way back to the palace to battle with Jafar, who turns into a huge monster snake. Aladdin tells Jafar that his work has been impressive so far, but it's no match for what the genie can do. Jafar realizes Aladdin is right. Then, Jafar makes his third wish. He demands to be made into an all-powerful genie.
Okay, but the downside to being a genie is that you got trapped inside a lamp for thousands and thousands of years. Jafar doesn't think this one all the way through and ends up falling victim to his own hubris. At least it's not the first one.
And at last, everything went normal. Aladdin uses his final wish to free Genie from being a genie to a normal human, not being a genie or just being a human.
And the Sultan, the original one, changes the law so that Jasmine can marry anyone that she wants.
And even if that man has grown up in abject poverty and will to rule over an entire kingdom someday. Hey, it's cool. He's happy, everyone's happy. Aladdin and Jasmine sing, blah blah blah. There are fireworks and the end.
The time when we hear the certain call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, oh, it is time to let our hand to live the greatest gift of all.
We can go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change. We are all a part of God's great big family, and the truth, no love is all we need.
We are the world, we are the children, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making. We're saving someone's life. It's true, we'll make a better state, just you and me.
Oh, send them your heart, so they know that someone cares, and their lives will be turning stone to bread, and so we all must lend a helping hand.
We are the world, we are the children, we are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making, we're saving our own life. It's true, we'll make a brighter day, just you and me. When you're down and out, there seems no hope at all. And if you just believe, there's no way we can fall. Well, 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 let us realize that change can only come when we stand. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's